kind of think about it, a fundraising environment is harder than it has been in the past. So what kind of, not just secondary funds, maybe it also applies to the primary funds. Who is getting the assets? Are these the large guys or are these the smaller guys? And where do you think is a better opportunity? Anybody can take this question.
There's some bias probably here at the table or at the dais up here. I'll start. I mean, we have a niche strategy, so we don't compete against what was Goldman's last secondary fund? 12 billion? 20 billion. Okay, that's like pretty big. We are raising a $1 billion fund to focus on finding really the highest quality companies, whether they're in an LP secondary, a GP secondary. We don't do venture direct, so we won't be competing there. Focus on the middle part of the market where we have exceptional coverage. I think that there's a place, Seema, for all LPs, whether you're, you know, Adia and you need to put $2 billion to work per year, you can find a home for that in the secondary market. Probably a little more difficult to partner with us if that's what you need to deploy. So, you know, we quite like that middle segment of the market where there are thousands of high quality companies backed by thousands of very talented sponsors, but are just a little too small for a Goldman $20 billion secondary fund, you know, to take interest in an $85 million waste management company, you know, based in the Midwest. Whereas for us, you know, we know how to extract value from that transaction. We know the partners, we may know the management. And so that's where we're focused. But I think there's lanes for probably, you know, every LP, but I'm biased. So I like the middle cycle.
Well, so I was going to say, in UX, you have this same data. And I think you alluded to this earlier, Michelle. The reality is if you have the stomach for it and the team to identify these managers, the small and middle markets outperform the large markets. Now there's more vol, right? I mean, I always refer to it as this shark bite because I think about teaching it to my kids, which is there's more vol in the small market. There's more
teaching
less vol
his
in the
kids
market.
About secondary.
Yeah, exactly. Well, I'm a very boring parent. You know, there's more vol, but more absolute return the further down market you go. And so if you've got a team that can mine the small and middle markets and find those managers, we found those to be very attractive. That's been true across market cycles. And I think we've got a bias towards small and middle market as well in this market environment, which is there's more exit optionality. The big guys are tied to big strategics or to IPOs to get out of their businesses. Small guys, you buy a business with $10 million of EBITDA and $100 million of revenue. The reality is that can get funded today. That can get debt funded by a direct lender. It can get bought by a middle market private equity firm. It can get bought by a smaller strategic. And so, you know, in addition to the absolute return part, I think we have more shots on goal in terms of creating liquidity in a market environment that for the next 18 to 24 months is going to suffer from a lack of liquidity.
Thank you, everybody. This was a great panel. Bye-bye.
Thank you.